Hello friends, my name is Ameen and welcome to the AMEEN'S Engineering channel. This is second class for basic thermodynamics. This video contains basic definitions like state, point function and path function, thermodynamic properties, processes and cycle, types of properties in which intensive properties and extensive properties, types of processes in which reversible and irreversible process, flow and non-flow process and quasi-static process. Let we start with basic definition like state, point function and path function. State. State is defined as each unique condition of a system is called as state. You can see on this graph, every point is a state. Now we will define point function. It follows from the definition of the state that each property has a single value at each state. These all properties are point functions. You can see on graph 1, 2 and 3 are point functions. Path function. The succession of states passed through during a change of state is called the path function. As you can see on graph 1 to 2 and 2 to 3 are the path functions. Now we will discuss about thermodynamic properties, processes and cycle. Properties of systems. A property of a system is a characteristic of the system which depends upon its state but not upon how the state is reached. Properties are the coordinates to describe the state of system. There are two sorts of properties. One is intensive properties and another one is extensive properties. Now we will see intensive properties. These properties do not depend on the mass of the system. Example, temperature, pressure, density, specific volume, specific heat, specific enthalpy, etc. Next is extensive properties. These properties depends on the mass of the system. Example, volume, energy, heat capacity, enthalpy, etc. Extensive properties are often divided by mass associated with them to obtain the intensive properties. For example, if the volume of a system of mass m is v, then the specific volume of matter within the system is v by m, which is an intensive property. Next we will see process. A process occurs when the system undergoes a change in a state or an energy transfer at a steady state. Following are the types of processes: reversible process, irreversible process, non-flow process, flow process and quasi-static process. Now we will see types of processes. This type of process is reversible process. A process when reversed in direction follows the same path as that of the forward path without having any effect on system and surrounding is called as reversible process. As shown in this diagram, both the directions are in same direction. Second is irreversible process. The process which is not reversible is known as irreversible process. As shown in this graph, both the directions are in opposite directions. All actual processes are irreversible process. Next is non-flow process. A process may be non-flow in which a fixed mass within the defined boundary is undergoing a change of state. Example, a substance which is being heated in a closed cylinder undergoes non-flow process. Closed system undergoes non-flow process as shown in this diagram. When the gas molecules are heated, the piston will rise. Next type of process is flow process. A flow process may be a process in which mass is entering and leaving through the boundary of a system. For example, open system undergo flow process. As shown in this diagram, when masses get into the cylinder, it will come out through the cylinder. Last type of process is quasi-static process. Quasi means almost. This process is a succession of equilibrium states and infinite slowness is its characteristics. A quasi-static process is also called as reversible process. It is same as that of reversible process, but slowness is its characteristics. Next is cycle. Any process or series of processes whose initial and end states are identical is termed as cycle. Or a system is said to have undergone a cycle when the initial and final points are same. For a cycle, change in property is zero. As shown in this graph, both initial and end point is one. Next, we will see the difference between point function and path function. Point function. When two properties locate a point on the graph, then those properties are called as point function. Example, pressure, temperature, volume, etc. Path function. There are certain quantities which cannot be located on a graph by a point, but are given by the area on that graph. In that case, the area on the graph pertaining to the particular process is a function of the path of the process. Such quantities are called path function. Example, heat and work. Point functions are exact differential. As you can see in this equation, integral 1 to 2 dv is equal to v2 minus v1, an exact differential. Whereas in path function, heat and work are inexact differential. Change cannot be written as difference between their end states. Thus, integral of limit 1 to 2 delta q is not equal to q2 minus q1 and is shown as q1 to 2. Similarly, for work, integral of limit between 1 to 2 delta w is not equal to w2 minus w1 and it's shown as w1 to 2. Here, in point function, d is used to denote exact differential, and in path function, delta is used to denote the inexact differential. To watch previous video, click on I button at right corner. Do like, share and comment. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.